Hi students, all of you, welcome to the online class. Today we are going to discuss the previous year's questions from the chapter Some Basic Principles of Organic Chemistry. In your material, page number 513. Page number 513. Question number 64. Read the question number 64. Question number 64. Yes, what is the question? The most stable carbanion among the following is. The most stable carbanion among the following. Most stable carbanion. What is meant by carbanion? Carbon with negative charge is called as carbanion. And in your options, if you observe the fourth option, that is a D, option D. Option D, what is given in option D? That is benzene ring, single bond, CH2 minus, para position is occupied with NO2 group. NO2 group is an example of electron withdrawing group. All of you know, NO2 group is an example of electron withdrawing group. And carbanions are classified into three types. Primary carbanion, secondary carbanion, tertiary carbanion. So according to the order of stability of carbanions, which carbanion is more stable? Primary carbanion is more stable than secondary. Secondary carbanion is more stable than tertiary. Here you are seeing CH2 minus. So this is a primary carbanion. So primary carbanion is more stable. And para position is occupied with which type of group? Electron withdrawing group. As a result of electron withdrawing group, here the bonded electrons are attracted towards para carbon. Here the bonded electrons are attracted towards para carbon. Here the bonded electrons are attracted towards para carbon. So here this negative charge is attracted towards this carbon, first carbon. So this negative charge is getting decreased. Electron density is getting decreased. As a result, stability is going to get increased. So the answer is option D. Next, question number 67. Read the question number 67. All of you read the question number 67. Very, very important question. Question number 67. So today we are discussing all the previous year's questions from the chapter Basic Principles of Organic Chemistry. Question number 67. The nucleophilicity order. Nucleophilicity order that is given as, if you go for the option C, what is given in option C? CH3 with minus charge greater than NH2 minus greater than OH minus. Actually, we have to write like this. OH minus greater than F minus. All of you know nucleophiles. What is meant by nucleophile? What is meant by a nucleophile? Electron rich spaces are called as nucleophiles. And the nucleophiles, some of the nucleophiles may contain negative charge. Here, CH3 containing negative charge, NH2 containing negative charge, OH containing negative charge, F containing negative charge. Among all of this, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine. Which one is more electronegative? Among the carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, which one is more electronegative?
Fluorine.
Yes, fluorine is more electronegative. When fluorine is more electronegative, it is ready to accept electrons. Being fluorine, more electronegative, fluorine ready to accept electrons, but not ready to donate electrons. What is meant by nucleophile? What is meant by nucleophile? Electron donating species is called as nucleophile. electron donating spaces are called as nucleophiles. So being fluorine more electronegative, fluorine is ready to accept electrons but not ready to donate electrons. So F minus is having less electron donating tendency. Then we can say that F minus is having less nucleophilicity. Whereas among the carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, which one is having less electronegativity? Carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, which one is having less electronegativity? Yes, carbon is having less electronegativity. Carbon is less electronegative. Being less electronegative carbon, it is having negative charge, means this space is ready to donate electrons. Hence, we can say that CH3 minus is more capable to donate the electrons. Hence, CH3 minus is having more nucleophilicity, whereas F minus is having less nucleophilicity. As the electronegativity increases, nucleophilicity decreases. Once again, as the electronegativity increases, nucleophilicity get decreases. So this is order of correct order of nucleophilicity of the given species. Very, very, very important bit. Yes, some students are not ready to listen the class during the online classes. That's why I'm sending the recorded videos. At least, please watch the recorded videos. Okay, moving to the next page. Question number 69. Question number 69. Read the question number 69. Question number 69. All of you read the question number 69. Polarization of electrons. Polarization of electrons in polarization of electrons in acrolein. Polarization of electrons in acrolein may be written as. What is acrolein means? A vinyl group. This is a vinyl group attached with aldehyde group. Vinyl group attached to aldehyde group. What is aldehyde group? Single bond C, double bond O, single bond H is called as aldehyde group. So this compound, CH2, double bond CH, single bond C, double bond O, CH. CH2, double bond CH, single bond C, double bond O, single bond H. So that is represented as CH2, double bond CH, single bond C, single bond H. This hydrogen is represented here and double bond is represented here. Double bond oxygen is represented here. Among all of these, carbon, carbon, carbon and oxygen, which one is more electronegative? Oxygen is more electronegative. So being oxygen more electronegative, oxygen is going to get partial negative charge. Remaining carbons get partial positive charges. So here carbon get partial positive charge, here carbon get partial positive charge, here carbon get partial positive charge. If you observe the option D, see the option D. Yes, in option D you can find, you can find this is a carbon having partial positive charge, this is a carbon oxygen, this is oxygen having partial negative charge. Why? Because means oxygen is more electronegative. So electronegative atom gets partial negative charge, electropositive atoms or less electronegative atoms gets partial positive charge. So here you have to remember the name acrolein. The formula is CH2 double bond CH, single bond C, double bond O, single bond H. Acrolein contains which functional group? Text me your answer. Acrolein contain which functional group? Acrolein containing which functional group? Text me in the chat box if you understood the answer. And moving to the next question, question number 70. During the online class, I'm going to ask some questions. If you are unable to text in the chat box, later you can give your answer to my WhatsApp number, right? Yes, question number 70, very, very, very important model. Actually, it is very wrong to say important, unimportant, but nowadays the trend is like that. So that's why I'm using the word. I'm very sorry to use that word. Select the most stable carbocation. select most stable carbocation. Most stable carbocation. Yes, can you tell me what is the correct order of stability of carbocations? What is the correct order of stability of carbocations? 3 degree tertiary greater than 2 degree secondary greater than 1 degree primary greater than methyl carbocations. Methyl carbocation means CH3+. So among the given options, if you go for option B, what is option B? That is single bond, 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 single bond. So this is given in the option B. Here you are seeing plus charge. Yes, if you observe that plus charge containing carbon, what is the type of carbon? Whether it is primary carbon or secondary carbon or tertiary carbon, which type of carbon it is? Can you text me which type of carbon it is? Here, this is the carbon bonded with one carbon, second carbon, third carbon. So which type of carbon it is? If a carbon bonded with three other carbons directly, that is a 3-degree carbon, tertiary carbon. See this one? This is a carbon bonded to three carbons. 1, 2, 3. So this carbon is known as which type of carbon? Tertiary carbon. Hence, this carbocation is an example of tertiary carbocation. Tertiary carbocations. Yes, already we know tertiary carbocations are more stable. So option B is correct. Most important model, as already I mentioned the star here. Next question number 73. Only 54 students are online. Among the 100 plus students, only 54 students are online. What about the remaining students? What their parents are doing? What their students are doing? We don't know. Whether they are interested towards the online class or not, we don't know. Question number 73. Read the question number 73. Question number 73. Consider the following carbocations. What are the carbocations given? Roman number 1, C6H5, CH2+. This is a primary carbocation. Roman number 2, what is Roman number 2? C6H5, CH2+. This is also a primary carbocation. Roman number 3, C6H5, CH3, this carbon with positive charge, it is a secondary carbocation, 2-degree carbocation. Roman number 4, C6H5, C+, CH3 taken twice. So the first one is a first degree carbocation, second one is a first degree carbocation, third one is second degree carbocation, fourth one is 3-degree carbocation. So what is the correct order of stability of carbocations? If you check the option A, what is given in option A? Roman number 2 is lesser stable than Roman number 2. What is Roman number 2? What is in Roman number 2? Primary carbocation. This is the primary carbocation is lesser stable than Roman number 1. Roman number 1 is also primary carbocation. Lesser stable than Roman number 3. Secondary carbocation is lesser stable than Roman number 4. So this is the correct order of stability of carbocations. My dear students, all of you know, tertiary carbocations are more stable than, secondary carbocations are more stable than primary carbocations. Yes, all of you know this one. But coming to this one, Roman number 1 is the primary carbocation. Roman number 2 is also primary carbocation. Whereas Roman number 3, Roman number 4 are secondary degree and third degree carbocations. There is no confusion. This is less stable. Roman number 3 is less stable than Roman number 4. Now my question is, why Roman number 2 is lesser stable than? Say this one. Roman number 2 is lesser stable than Roman number 1. Can you guess any answer? Can you give any reason why Roman number 2 is lesser stable than Roman number 1? Very simple logic. Here, the carbocation carbon is bonded to CH2 carbon. Whereas here, carbocation carbon is bonded to phenyl carbon. Once again, in this case, the carbocation carbon is bonded to CH2 carbon. Whereas in this case, the first degree carbocation carbon is bonded to phenyl carbon. Because of this phenyl group, here you can expect a resonance structures. This is called as benzyl carbocation. Benzyl. This name is benzyl carbocation. Benzyl carbocation. Benzyl carbocation is going to have more number of resonance structures. Benzyl carbocation is having more number of resonance structures. So even though Roman number 1 carbocation C6H5CH2+, Roman number 2 C6H5CH2CH2+, both are first degree carbocations, but Roman number 1 is benzyl carbocation. It is going to have more number of resonating structures. Hence, with compared to Roman number 2, Roman number 1 is more stable. Then we can write the order. Roman number 2 is less stable than Roman number 1. Roman number 1 less stable than Roman number 3. Roman number 3 is less stable than Roman number 4. Very important model. Stability of carbocations, carbanions, carbon free radicals. It is a very, very, very important concept. Did you understood? Text me your response. Did you understood? Did you understood, my dear students? Yes, thank you. Yes, question number 75. Question number 75. Read the question number 75. Read the question number 75. Question number 75. Aldehyde is the rearrangement product of. Aldehyde is the rearrangement product of. Aldehyde is the rearrangement product of dash. Yes, all of you know isomerism. One type of isomerism is keto enol tautomerism. In the classes, so many times I explained in the offline classes, keto enol tautomerism. Suppose if I am taking vinyl, what is meant by vinyl? CH2. CH2, double bond, CH single bond. This group is called as vinyl. If it is bonded with OH group, then it is called as vinyl alcohol. Double bond is present here, in OH group is present here, ol. Vinyl alcohol is an example of enol. Vinyl alcohol, it is an example of enol. Double bond is present here, in. Single bond OH is there, ol. Vinyl alcohol is enol. In this enol, oxygen bonded with OH, oxygen is containing two lone pairs of electrons. When this bond is going to be shifted between carbon and oxygen, here hydrogen is going to be transferred towards this CH2. Then CH2 becomes CH3. Then what we can write? CH2 becomes CH3. And this bond is going to be delocalized towards this carbon. Then double bond becomes a single bond, right? Then CH is present here. C single bond, H is present. Between carbon and oxygen, single bond becomes double bond. Single bond becomes double bond. CH3 single bond, C double bond was single bond H. This is called as acetaldehyde. Acetaldehyde, it is an example of aldehyde. From where it is coming? Aldehyde is coming from enol. Yes, see the option. Option C. If you observe option C, what is given in option C? Vinyl alcohol. What is the formula of vinyl alcohol? CH2 double bond, CH single bond, OH. So this type of isomerism is called as keto enol tautomerism. This concept is also important. Keto enol tautomerism. Already in the class also I explained this one, in the offline class also. Next, question number 77. Read the question number 77. Only 3 minutes is there. Read the question number 77. Which of the following is most stable? Can you text me the answer? Not by seeing the options. By understanding the concept. Try to text me your answer. Question number 77. Which of the following is most stable? Which of the following is most stable? Which of the following is most stable? Which one of the following is most stable? Yes, option is A. If you see the option A, what is given in option A? PH3 taken thrice C+. My dear students, already I said, what is meant by PH? PH stands for phenyl group. What is meant by phenyl group? Benzene ring with single bond is called as phenyl group. Benzene ring with single bond is nothing but C6H5 single bond. Here, PH, how many times? 3 times. So this is called as triphenyl PH3. This is called as triphenyl. C+ is called as carbocation. Triphenyl carbocation. How can you represent triphenyl carbocation? The triphenyl carbocation can be represented as C+ single bond C6H5, single bond C6H5, single bond C6H5. Just now, in the last example, I said when a carbocation carbon is directly bonded to a phenyl group, here we can expect more number of resonance structures. Here also, because of this phenyl group, here we can expect more number of resonance structures that are stabilizing the carbocation. And because of this phenyl group also, we can expect more number of resonance structures that are causing to stability of carbocation. So whenever a carbocation carbon is directly bonded to phenyl groups, that carbocation is more stable. So triphenyl carbocation is more stable among the given options. So this is all about today's class. If you have any doubts, you can call me on my WhatsApp number between 7:30 p.m. to 9 p.m. And if you want any further Zoom classes, additional Zoom classes individually, I can take the class for personal students. Right? Just text me whether the class is understood or not. All of you, please give a response whether the class is understood or not. Yes, remaining who are not watching the online classes, please go through my YouTube channel. There you can find the video lectures. You can watch any time, any number of times. All of you know about my YouTube channel, CSN Chemistry Channel. CSN Chemistry Channel. There you can find all the recorded video lectures. Please try to watch those video lectures. And every day you have to send the classwork as well as homework, whatever you are doing regarding CET, NEET, JEE. You have to write in the notebook and you have to send that notebook as a PDF to my WhatsApp number. Yes. Thank you, one and all. Stay home, stay safe. Please wear the mask. Try to use double mask when you are going outside. Have a nice day. Signing off, this is your chemistry lecture, Sister Naidu.